Welcome back to Innocence Tarot. We're going to do another Divine Masculine update. We're going to use Journey to Divine Masculine. After I finish shuffling, I will sit up here and turn down the music after I finish shuffling. Okay? Let's get into this energy. Right, for real, our divine masters do be having us sitting up here fucking triggered. Okay, let me set the karma back up the right way. Okay, sorry about that, you guys. Trying to turn down the music. Okay, our divine masters do be having us fucking triggered. I love that song. Like, for real, just want to scream it. Is that triggered? Just fucking triggered, motherfucker. Yeah, you did it. You did it. Okay. Let me get four more cards, Spirit, and then we're going to get into this reading. Okay, let me fix this camera again. I'm sorry. Okay, can y'all see? Okay. All right. Sorry about that. Okay, so it looked like Divine Masculine still going through the same old bullshit. He's still going through bullshit, okay? Divine Masculine, he ready to sit up here and take the mask off, okay? He ready to take the mask off. Divine Masculine is already sitting up here detaching his ass away from this karmic. Divine Masculine don't want to sit up here and be with this karmic. Divine Masculine is sitting up here pretending that he want to be with this karmic. Okay, I don't even think Divine Masculine want to be around the karmic or the kids that he got with her ass or her kids, okay? Divine Masculine is tired of deceiving, walking around, acting like everything, like he happy about everything, okay? Within that family unit, okay? He detaching away from the shit, okay? Mm-mm. I know it might sound ugly, but Divine Masculine, he's seeing how the karmic is and he's seeing how these kids is, okay? And what he's realizing about this karmic and her kids is that the apple don't fall too far from the tree, okay? They don't appreciate him, make him feel good about himself, and he don't feel appreciated within this family, okay? Divine Masculine is constipating on sitting up here walking away. Divine Masculine don't want to sit up here and be with her ass no more. And Divine Masculine don't want to sit up here and be in that marriage with that karmic no more. Okay? Yep. Mm-hmm. Talking to you, karmic. Yep. You don't want to be with your dumb ass no more, bitch. The gig is up. Okay? Yes, Divine Masculine is ready to sit up here and walk away from your dog face ass. Yep. Mm-hmm. He tired of feeding your ass. Okay? Yes, Divine Masculine, he want to sit up here and want a new beginning, and he want to sit up here and work with Divine Feminine, okay? I was trying to sit up here and see how I could do it better. Okay. Yeah, Divine Masculine want a new beginning with you, Divine Feminine. He want to work as a team with you because Divine Masculine been sitting back thinking, okay? And Divine Masculine want this new beginning because Divine Masculine, he been sitting up here seeing all the synchronicities. Divine Masculine been sitting up here just getting all the type of downloads from spirit and everything else. And Divine Masculine can't deny the signs that he's seen. He's no longer trying to deny the way that he sit up here and feels, okay? As Divine Masculine is sitting up here in solitude, Divine Masculine realizes that you is the one that really completes him. You're the one that really has his heart. Divine Masculine knows that he's been lying to himself all this time, okay? You is the one that always had his heart. Divine Masculine knows, without a shadow of a doubt, that you sit up here and you earned it, okay? Divine Feminine, you earned your Divine Masculine fair and square way before you even found out that you was a Divine Feminine, okay? You put the work in, okay? And Divine Masculine, like, damn, my heart is really supposed to be to my Divine Feminine. Like, she earned it. She fought for me. She fed me. She was there when I was going through shit. She was there when I was in my prime. She was the one that I created memories and everything with. She's really the one that I want to be with, okay? This is what he then came up with as he then sat in solitude. God been working on Divine Masculine, making Divine Masculine think different, okay? And as Divine Masculine be sitting there in solitude and everything, thinking about how he betrayed you, how he did you, it breaks Divine Masculine's heart on how he shitted on you and his love, okay? You did nothing to Divine Masculine. He sit back and he thinks like, damn, Divine Feminine didn't cheat on me. She wasn't after my money. She treated my kids good. She did all these great ass fucking things for me. And I got the audacity to hurt her, play her like he did. He just pissed the fuck off at himself, which he should be. Divine Masculine know that you didn't deserve to be in separation with him, okay? No, you didn't. Divine Masculine got the clarity of that. Oh, upside down. Divine Masculine got the clarity of that, okay? Divine Masculine feel like, damn, how could he sit up here and put you in that situation as lovable as you have been to your Divine Masculine, okay? For him to back betray you, backstab you, put 10 knives in your back, and then go on with his life like nothing ever happened. Okay? Divine Masculine is so fucking pissed at his fucking self, okay? Yeah, he heartbroken. Mm-hmm. God making Divine Masculine feel it. He feeling it. He getting his ass whooped left and right by God, Jesus, the angel, ancestors, everybody taking getting they lick in for Divine Masculine, okay? Making Divine Masculine see on how loyal and how dedicated you was to the situation, okay? Yes, Divine Masculine got the clarity. He knows that you was loyal, and he knows that he's supposed to be with you, growing old with you, because you earned his love. Fair and square, okay? Fair and square. Way before you even knew about this spirituality, hands down, you set up here, earned your Divine Masculine. Divine Masculine sits up here and gets to thinking about everything and how loyal and dedicated you was to him. And he just feels like shit, okay? He feels like shit. Divine masculine is getting the signs. Okay? God is unthawing his cold ass heart, okay? To the point that divine masculine is ready to surrender to this love. He ain't got no other choice. Because God, the angels, and the ancestors, they all laughing at him. Putting shit in his dreams, letting him know that you're about to meet somebody else, this and that. Letting him, reminding him how loyal you was. The angels and the ancestors reminding him on everything that you've been through with him, how he was there for him, his mama, his kids, and everything else. Okay, divine masculine has no other choice but to surrender. Because God's going to have his way. God don't care what divine feminine got to say, what divine masculine got to say. God going to have his way. Okay, divine, and the Most High said, divine masculine, I had enough of your shit, and it's time for you to surrender. Okay? You going to wish that you did. Okay? So divine masculine getting the signs to surrender. Okay? Divine masculine getting the signs that he fucked up. Okay? And divine masculine, he realized that he was a coward in how he handled things, okay? He was a coward in how he handled things, and divine masculine was in super denial. Divine masculine didn't think that he loved you like he really loved you. Divine masculine knew he had feelings for you, but divine masculine was in denial on how deep that love ran until you got separated, okay? He know that he took the coward's way out. Divine masculine should be ashamed of himself, but divine masculine did those things because of the way that he was raised, okay? Divine masculine, he be thinking that he doing shit the right way, trying to spare somebody feelings, but divine masculine still hurts a person anyways, okay? Even when he not trying to, okay? Divine masculine wasn't taught the right way. He just wasn't. He didn't get that nurturing that he needed to the point that it's hard for him to sit up here and give it out. So that's why divine masculine is very impulsive. This is why he makes these outrageous fucking decisions without thinking first. He just jumps in head first, okay? And he does things and then he backs out of it like a coward, like he ain't did nothing, okay? This is why divine masculine handled it like that, okay? But God got his ass on the right track right now. He ready to surrender to this twin flame journey. He will surrender to this twin flame journey or his whole life will be destroyed, okay? Because God ain't playing with him, okay? God ain't playing with us either. We just learned over the different lessons and we learned to take heed to the signs, okay? We learned not to play with God, okay? That's what we ain't finna box with because our arms ain't long enough to do so, okay? We've been surrendered to God. Now divine masculine surrendered to God and this twin flame journey, knowing that he has to make things right, knowing that he has to surrender, knowing that he has to take accountability on how he treated you, how he shitted on you, how he put 10 knives in your back and then went on with his fucking life like he ain't never, ever fucking did nothing. Okay? Yeah, divine masculine's feeling it. Okay? Mm-hmm. He sure is feeling it. Okay? No, God said he tired of divine masculine sitting up here throwing rocks at a fucking glass door and then hiding his hands like he ain't did nothing, like he ain't hurt people. Okay? No, God ain't letting you take the coward way out of this. God said, you're going to make this shit right. You're going to make this shit right with divine feminine or else you least going to give her the apology that she deserves. You're going to take accountability for being that coward ass, pussy ass that your ass was on the way that you handled that shit, okay? And divine masculine got full clarity that he got to sit up here and come back and work as a team with you, ask you for your apology, stop self-deceiving shit, okay? Take that fucking mask off and come with some real facts, okay? And divine masculine got to sit up here and come out of his pride. Divine masculine got to stop sitting up here playing the victim, acting like he was the one that was hurt. Divine masculine got to do what's right, okay? This is the clarity that he's having. Divine masculine wants to sit up here and come back to his true love, his soulmate. Divine masculine does not know you at the present moment as a twin flame. He thinks that you're his soulmate. He thinks that it's meant to be. Divine masculine is finally being able to see what you brought to the table, divine feminine. Okay? He got the clarity on that. Okay? And what he realized is you everything that a person can want. You everything that a person can need. And for him to mishandle you, treat you like he treated you like some bitch off the street. Mm-mm. He didn't know who he was fucking with. He he did not know who the fuck he was fucking with. But his ass wanted to sit up here and be in denial. Divine Master wanted to sit up here and act like you wasn't, like you just wasn't good enough or some shit, okay? No, Divine Masculine was used to dealing with hot mess ass, hood rat ass bitches. Divine Masculine like sitting up here dealing with a hoe, okay? I thought you wanted a hoe in the bedroom and you wanted the lady in the streets. Divine Masculine got heard the shit backwards, okay? Divine Masculine's in denial. He knew that you was a high-valued woman. He knew that you... He knew. He always knew deep down in his heart, and he went over and above to make you feel like you wasn't shit. This is why I just want to slap the shit out of Divine Masculine. He did that shit on purpose, okay, to make you feel like shit, and then he pumped up and went and flaunted the hood rat bitch, okay, over some sex. It's a damn shame when sex can make you lose your fucking mind, okay? Thank God I'm a woman. I would not trade being a woman. I wouldn't want to be a man to save my life, because anything they brush against, they weenie get hard. They hard if they look at something. They hard if they this and that. We're not like that, okay? Mm-mm. You got to get us in the mood, okay? We got to be in that mood that we just got to feel it. Females, you know what I'm saying? But guys, mm-mm, they got it bad. They got it bad. They just got a fucking, they got a weenie that's called maniac. And maniac, which is the weenie, want to do what he want to do. Maniac don't give a fuck if you're in a relationship. Maniac don't give a damn what's going on with you. Maniac want to do what he want to do when he want to do it, okay? That's what I'm talking about, his tallywhacker, his weenie, okay? Yeah, his name is Maniac, okay? We're going to name him Maniac because he got his own brain. And Maniac been fucking up Divine Masculine's life for the longest, okay? Maniac be having Divine Masculine in all type of chaotic situations on some sex. Divine Masculine, his biggest downfall is sex, okay? He a sucker for some sex, okay? He do anything strange, long as somebody can get him off the way that he want to be got off, okay? And he be entertaining these hoes. And Maniac put him in a lot of chaotic moments, okay? When Divine Masculine should use his big head, not his little head, okay? But yeah, Divine Masculine, Karma been whooping his ass. He ready to work as a team with you. He ready to sit up here, travel, come to you, make things right, okay? He coming with a big smile like he ain't never did shit, okay? Ready to work with you, okay? Divine Masculine, he want to make things right when he was being a coward, the way that he was treating you, okay? Mm-hmm. Divine Masculine want to be independent, away from this karmic, okay? Divine Masculine is already sitting up here detaching his way. Detaching away from the fucking karmic, okay? He already done made up his mind. He already being funny. He already walking around the house not speaking, being to himself and everything. Divine Masculine trying to make this karmic break up with him. Divine Masculine trying to make this karmic get so mad till he create his own tower moment. This is what Divine Masculine is doing with this karmic, okay? Divine Masculine has thought this shit up real good and clear. And Divine Masculine realizes what he feels, okay, is that he should detach his way away from it. And then the karmic will get very angry to the point that she will want to break up with him so he don't be feeling like shit afterwards. Because Divine Masculine knows that he's sitting up here planning to make his way back to you. Divine Masculine already sitting up here ready to get you a gift. Divine Masculine already planning on sitting up here reconciling with you. But yet Divine Masculine is still being, okay, vindictive, playing games with this karmic, okay, suppressing the way that he sit up here and feel instead of just telling the karmic on how he really feels. This is what Divine Masculine, lifetime after lifetime after lifetime, okay, he keeps on sitting up here missing the lesson. God wants Divine Masculine to sit up here and be honest. Won't Divine Masculine sit up here and tell the truth on how he sit up here and feels, okay? God wants Divine Masculine to sit up here and tell the karmic that you complete him, that he wants to sit up here and he wants to walk away from this marriage, okay? He wants Divine Masculine to tell the truth, okay? That he's in love with Divine Feminine and that he wants to reconcile and that he wants to sit up here and walk away. But Divine Masculine always trying to take the coward's way out of shit, okay? Trying to sit up here and do some underhanded shit, and then everything always turned to a chaotic situation. No, Divine Masculine got to sit up here and be honest and let that bitch know why the fuck he's sitting up here detaching away from her. Why he don't want to sit up here and be with her. He didn't care about hurting your feelings when he walked away from you, Divine Feminine. So why should he care about hurting the fucking karmic's feeling to walk away from that bitch and they family? He didn't have no problem walking away from you and your kids, okay? For real. But he's sitting up here detaching, okay? Sitting around a karmic, heartbroken, wishing that he could be with you, but still trying to spare this bitch feelings, okay? Mm-hmm. Still got his head up in the clouds on how he gonna sit up here and go about shit, okay? And it's the truth. Divine Masculine got motherfucking nerve, okay? Divine Masculine sitting up here need to learn how to put boundaries up. He need to stop. He need to learn how to put boundaries up. Divine Masculine need to stop sitting up here ghosting people and keep it real. Divine Masculine is soul searching, trying to sit up here and figure out how he gonna go about the shit. Okay, your Divine Masculine might like to wear hats. Okay. Divine Masculine wants to see whatever decision he makes. He wants to make sure that he's gonna be stable and make sure that the kids that he has with her, they stable and have the things that they need, okay? Divine Masculine is listening to a lot of music in his comfort zone, thinking a whole lot. Divine Masculine spirit guides is working on him, telling him that he needs to stop sitting up here playing games. He needs to confess the truth. He needs to let all parties know exactly what's going on before he sit up here and try to travel to you. Divine Masculine got to take that fucking mask off if he want to sit up here and even have a conversation with you. He got to take that mask off. And he cannot sit up here and come towards you unless he's ready to sit up here and walk away from the karmic. Okay? He got to be ready to walk away from her ass. And he needs to take that mask off. Divine Masculine sitting up here listening to a whole lot of music. Okay, Divine Masculine knows that he just feels unworthy. Divine Masculine feels unworthy because you were such a lovable, loyal, down-to-earth fucking person. And Divine Masculine just feel like you're not going to give him another chance. You're too good of a person. Divine Masculine knows that anybody else that would get you would be rich in value, rich with love, rich with everything that you bring to the table, Divine Feminine, okay? Anybody will be honored to have you. And Divine Masculine know that, okay? Divine Masculine is overindulging, stressed the fuck out, not trying to figure out on how he gonna go about the shit. The angels is laughing at him, whooping his ass on the daily, letting his ass know that he done fucked up time and time again. They just laughing at his ass, okay? Divine Masculine is contemplating on seeing on how he gonna sit up here and make things right. Divine Masculine wanna sit up here and work as a team with you. But Divine Masculine is contemplating, okay, if you gonna give him a new beginning. Okay, Divine Masculine wants to make sure and wants to come forward. He don't want to really break up with the karmic just yet, okay? Because he don't know if you're going to take him back or not, okay? Divine Masculine don't want to sit up here and lose in both situations. So Divine Masculine is constipating on wondering how he going to come back around, okay? Ask you for a new beginning. See how it is with you, okay? And to see if you're going to be willing to take his ass back, okay? Divine Masculine not ready to fully take off that mask yet. He's not fully ready. He's ready to walk away. He's already detaching away from the karmic. But Divine Masculine, it all counts if you take him back. If you take him back, he's going to dump the karmic right away. He's going to come back to you. But Divine Masculine, he already don't want the karmic. But he just not willing to take two losses, okay? So he's going to see if you're willing to give him a new beginning. Okay, he gonna take off this mask and be honest with you, push out his feelings, tell you how he feeling and every fucking thing else, and he gonna hear what you got to say. And if you tell him that you want him back, he gonna sit up here and walk away from this karmic and the family that he has with her. Divine Masculine is willing to do that if you're willing to take him back. But if you don't take him back, he gonna stay where he's put, where he's been comfortable at, okay? And this is what Divine Masculine been sitting up here thinking about in solitude, okay? Divine Masculine, he's very confident on how he's going about things to get the answers and facts that he needs about the situation, okay? Divine Masculine needs to see exactly how you're feeling about things, Divine Feminine. That's what he wants us to see, okay? Divine Masculine is ready to take this mask off, okay? Divine Masculine is so tired of pretending being somebody that he not. Sitting up here being in a relationship that he don't want to be in. All Divine Masculine wants to do is make things right. All Divine Masculine wants to sit up here do is just to sit up here and get this monkey off his back. Divine Masculine is so tired of going through karma, so tired of going through bullshit. He's so tired of learning lessons. He just wants you back and he want to start over. He just want to show you from there. But it don't work like that all the time, Divine Masculine. So Divine Masculine came up with another plan as well, okay, with this plan. He going to come in with a gift. He going to show you exactly how he feels about you or whatever gift he wants to give you, okay? Divine Masculine has been worked on with his spirituality. Ever since you and him have separated, God's been working on Divine Masculine, okay? And you will be real happy to not be around your Divine Masculine, okay? Even though he's been with the karmic over there living with her going, they've been going through it. That karmic been catching hell in that household, okay? Because God's been sitting up here waking Divine Masculine up. What Divine Masculine used to like, he don't like no more. Okay? So you wouldn't have wanted to be around your Divine Masculine while he was going through all these different changes and you know, Divine Masculine been going through it. Divine Masculine lost his identity for a minute. He surely did. Okay? Let me get another deck. Okay? Let me see. What deck do I want? No, let's just get some advice for the collective. Let me see how many more minutes I got before I have to go. Okay. We're going to use Unicorn Love, I believe it's called. And we're going to sit up here and see what message the spirit has to tell you. Okay. What advice do you have for the collective? What advice do you have for our Divine Feminines? Share when you share, everyone feels happy. Divine Feminine, God loves when you share, when you help people. When you give the homeless water, when you sit up here and you give them money, when you sit up here and you share, God is seeing that. And everything that you do give out, everything that you do help people with, God is going to give it back to you tenfold. Okay? God sees everything. His eyes is always awake. Okay? Relax. Everything is okay. Don't worry. It's all going to be fine. God don't want you worrying about nothing. God love you so much, he ain't gonna never ever see you down. And then when God sit up here and breaks you down, he rebuilds you better than you ever have been, okay? You already know that because you got your own relationship with God, okay? But you already know, relax, everything is gonna be all right because God is on your side. Yes, he is. It's okay to be different. You don't need to be like everyone else. You're perfect just as you are. And you are perfect just as you are, Divine Feminine. Don't give a fuck about what no hating ass bitch got to say or no hating ass dude, haters, they mamas, any fucking body, okay? You know better than that, okay? Hello? I know you hear me, Divine Feminine, because I'm knocking, okay? It's okay to be different. You're going to appreciate your difference, okay? Yes, it's all for a reason. Water. Drink more water and eat foods with water in them, such as fresh fruits and vegetables, okay? Drink more water, everybody. If you're snacking, you know you're eating a lot of salt and sugar and different things, wash that shit down with some extra water because we're getting up in age, okay? Water is very important right now. It makes you feel better. Your skin just be looking all good. If you break out and everything and you kind of have acne, you need to drink more water than anybody and watch that shit clear up. I'm trying to tell you, okay? Imagine, what would you see, feel, think, and hear if your wishes came true? Oh, my God. If our wishes came true, I would be thanking my God, okay? My Lord and Savior, because he made it happen. I'd be sitting up here just thanking God. I'd probably cry because I'm a crier. When I'm happy, I cry. When I'm sad, I cry. Okay, I just be giving all praises to God, okay, because you know it's a miracle. And God does these type of things in the supernatural. You best believe it. Keep on manifesting. Keep on believing. Keep on trusting. Don't give up, okay? Prayers go up. Blessings come down, okay? Family culture. Learn more about your family's history. I mean, learn more about your family stories and history. Okay. Learn more about your family history and your ancestors and everything. I want to learn more about mine. Okay. My grandmother that passed, she was the only child. And she was a beautiful woman. Okay. And I just want to know more about my grandmother, but she passed away when I was like 7. But all my family, they be like, you're so much like your grandmother. You know, she loves shoes. She loves clothes. She's such a good person. She took care of her kids. Okay. My grandmother had 12 children. She was from Arkansas and she took care of all of them. And she lived a very good life, had property, all type of different things. Okay. And she did that. Okay. She continued to do that for all her kids. She was there for. And she was the only child, you know, and some of her kids appreciated her and some of her kids didn't appreciate her. Okay. And it just makes me mad when the older that I get and I hear these stories about her own kids and I'm able to see things, it just makes me want to slap the shit out of family. You know what I'm saying? Because family, it starts with family. Family, you know, family will let you down and hurt you before anybody will. But for your own kids to grow up and half of them treat you right and then the other half don't care about nothing except what you can do for them. Can you buy them a car? Can you get them a place and everything else? My grandmother got tired of that. Got tired of, you know, not being loved back. You know what I'm saying? And I get it. You know what I mean? I just get it. The more, you know, I be on my spiritual journey, I just get where she was and the place that she was at that time. And I just want you guys to all honor your grandmothers and everybody that was there for you because they didn't have to be, okay? There's a lot of people to check out, but a lot of people to stay, okay? But let me get back to the reading. I'm sorry, but I just want to just express that. Somebody needs to hear that, okay? Let me see. Okay, decide. It's time to... Oh, we did that one to see what we wanted, okay? It says, put your energy into basics and let go of assets. So God don't want you sitting up here stressing about a damn thing, okay? The more you don't stress, the more you praying for is going to come in, okay? Love from your parents, no matter what your mother and father do. Love you... Love them as much as you can, okay? No matter if your mother, your dad, if your dad was there, your mother wasn't there, whatever they have done, please forgive them. Forgive them for you, okay? They ain't all, a lot of parents ain't always right, okay? And it ain't no handbook to raising no children, okay? Our parents did the best that they could, okay? And when you have children, you able to see the different things. There ain't no handbook to raising no kids, but love your mother and your father, okay? Shit, my dad wasn't even around. My dad was in the military. Wherever he laid his hat was his home. And he had many children as well. And he didn't give us the attention like we felt like he should have. All of us have that same issue with him because he got so many different children as well. You know what I'm saying? But I still had to forgive him and I still had to love him and understand, you know, that you only get one mom and you only get one dad. And the main thing is, what did my guy say? He said, respect your mother and your father and your days will be longer upon the earth, okay? And if you don't, God said he'll make your life hard, okay? So you know when people disrespect their parents and shit, you do see them die early. You do see things happen to them and everything else, okay? So I'm just saying, don't bring no unnecessary...